much. We are happy to be here. We're proud to be here as well. I would like to introduce to Caroline Nagel, which is the project director from COBE Architects. I am the developer from the silo, and I'm one of the co-owners. NRE is the other owner, and they are also the one who constructed the building.
We are very proud and honored that we can be here. And actually, it's especially that we are now in the finalists for the tall buildings, because Copenhagen is actually not known, or Denmark is not really known for tall buildings. Normally, Copenhagen or Denmark is more known for the classical Danish design. You're all sitting on one of them from Arne Jacobsen, for example. Actually, it's also interesting that the city of Copenhagen also won in the monocle the prize of the most livability cities. It's also quite interesting that the city icon of Copenhagen is actually not very big, I have to say. It's a little mermaid. So it actually shows that Copenhagen has a kind of a totally other kind of approach. It's not really the tall buildings they are known of, but for example, the bicycle is one of the things which shows the identity of Copenhagen. And it's also quite interesting if you see the skyline of Copenhagen. It's mainly 5 to 6 floors high buildings, and then the peaks of the churches are making the skyline. So it should just explain to you that we are actually extremely proud that we can come with the silo project, an old grain silo, which gets transformed to a new kind of living silo. This shows the area in Copenhagen. It is in the old industrial harbor area. It's called the North Harbor. And it's a new area which gets developed in the next coming years. And the silo is one of the old babies, so to say, in this old area.
Yeah, as you can see here, it's one of the ships sailing. It's been delivering the grain to the silo. You can see the arrow pointing at the silo. This is some years back when I tried to buy the silo. I was not able to transform it at the time. I was not allowed to do it. It should be a grain silo. At the municipalities, they said you cannot transform it. So we had to wait a few years more, but finally we succeeded, and we have actually had a great job, because that's what we bought, and that's what we had to transform into a residential area. So you can't actually walk inside a grain silo. So this only consists of these tubes, like you see here. They are 60 meters high, and it was quite a job actually to see how we could do it. You can easily explain here how that works, but
yeah, that shows actually the main structure of the concrete silo, that you have this 4.5 times 4.5 meter grid system, and then you can see the northern part is where the mechanical tower were, and there you had the levels of the silo, and that is actually also going to be the new kind of the levels of the silo we went through the whole apartment, and
Yeah, that tells you a little bit of the transformation from the old grain silo to the new silo. We heard about pigeons before, and we had another problem with the pigeons, because the only inhabitants which we found when we bought the silo was about 500 pigeons inside the silo. So we didn't have the problem to avoid them outside, but we had to get them out before we started. It's been a long process also for us. We heard from some of the other that it has been for them as well. But as you see here, we had 20-something prototypes and models made before we found the version which you see right now. It's been a fantastic collaboration, and it's important, I think, to work with good architects, because they can always push the limits. And for us as the developers, I think it's important also to have some part of your heart into a project. If you don't have a passion for it, it don't really get to the final details, as we also heard. So that's what we're trying to do here.
And it shows a little bit of pin-up in the office, because also for us as an architect, it's one of the hardest jobs actually working with it, and that's because we actually were falling already in love in the old silo structure, this monolithic, very slim and aesthetic building. And it was the idea, how can you actually transform it into a livable house with a lot of openings, big balconies, and a new kind of facade. So the idea was actually, first of all, we figured out the program, and it's actually quite important and nice, actually, that you have this very open public floors in the ground floor, and then actually also a public floor, and then the housing in the middle. And it's how we transformed the silo was actually from inside out. So the silo got a new kind of jacket with all installations and windows and balconies in. And it's a galvanized steel facade we were approaching with, and that is also because of the where the silo is placed in the old industrial harbor, and it should also show the roughness of this what the silo was once in the old industrial harbor. Here you can see a section of the silo, and it's maybe a little bit strange to show the sections, but this actually shows the soul of the building. Each floor has a different floor height, and it is from 4 meters to 8 meters, the differences, and each level is very unique and have different spaces. So it's actually quite interesting what you can make out of this very robust and closed structure, how you can transform it to a new living block. A little bit more about the facade. We were using this galvanized steel facade, and it's a very geometrical facade where we are pushing the windows in and the balconies out. And that should also be that the balconies shouldn't look like that you're hanging it on. It should have had this very robust and monolithic look as the old silo had, the historical one. But then the balconies get perforated steel plates, so you actually get still the amazing view. But you also get quite protected on the balconies because it's quite windy at the North Harbor area, and you also are more protected according to the people can look into your apartments. This is one of my favorite shots, I have to say. It shows how the facade constructors, they place these huge elements. And the scale is also quite important, as especially for tiny Copenhagen, where the scale is quite small. It is just really impressive to see how, for example, these 6 meter high elements are going to place onto the concrete structure. And not only the architects, the owner, but also the constructors, we were really proud and happy working with this silo, and we were really putting a lot of energy and into it, as you also can see here. And this is that's what I told in the beginning, that we were in the beginning really falling in love with this very monolithic thing how the silo were, and it, we think we still manage it, that it has this old soul of the old silo. And there you can see the detailing of the galvanized steel facade and how precise things got welded together. This is just some examples about the floor plans. We have 39 apartments in the house with four kind of types, where we have the corner apartments, the one in the body, and then also the one to the one side. And it's a bit special that each apartment has minimum two balconies. And this shows insight from the silo, the transformation, that we try to keep the old history and also the old soul of the silo. So you can see that we cut this huge concrete elements out, and we kept the raw concrete left, and the facade got also placed from the outside to it, so you don't see the window frames, you get these amazing views towards the water. And you can also see the balconies that you can still see, look around, but you get still this amazing view. Yeah, and here you can see how people are living in it. Some are really, really took this raw and soulful experience into it. There's also some other experiences in the house.
Quite
we've
different,
seen.
Some of them,
yes.
Yeah.
And that also shows another kind of interior world, how people used to use these spaces, the more the white universe, the black universe, and this is the foyer and reception area when you enter your apartment. Yeah.
Here you can see also that the municipalities asked us to have public spaces at the ground floor and at the top floor. So what we have at the ground floor, here's the outside, you can see a small public space also from the outside. And this is the ground floor, which is now an exhibition space from the City and Port Development Company. So they show in this exhibition space how it's going to be in this new residential area. That's a few shots also from the restaurant, which on top, it has a 360 degree view. And if you live in Copenhagen, if you've been to Copenhagen, you know that there are not many high rises. So if you are here, you can actually see the whole city of Copenhagen, and you can even see to our neighboring country, which is Sweden.
Yeah. Here you can see from the outside also the restaurant has actually another kind, we call it as an add-on, the box on top, and it has a totally different kind of facade. It's the mirroring glass facade, which actually mirroring in the daytime the surroundings, and then in the nighttime you get the experience of the restaurant.
Here, it's something which we're fairly proud of. As we are a small country again, as I said, we don't have many TV series, so we're happy to see some of the American series and the new series, the last one they came out with. It's called The Simpsons in Denmark, and there we have a small picture of the silo, so we're happy for that. Thank you much. Thank you very much, everybody.